I'm Dr. William Stanton. I'm going to take the next few minutes to discuss a muscle-sparing total knee replacement. The anterior incision is made just like any other incision for a knee replacement in the front of the knee, usually about 6 inches in length. The muscle-sparing portion of the knee replacement is the next layer down. So instead of it cutting through any tendons, we go by the tendon of the patellar tendon, around the kneecap, and then just inside one of the muscles called the vastus medialis obliquus, called the VMO. Through that incision, through the deep tissue, we're able then to expose the knee. The knee replacement is then performed, first of all, by cutting about 10 to 12 millimeters off the end of the femur. This is then replaced with a metal cap. We also use material called bone cement that's more like a grout in between the metal and the patient's bone. The leg bone is addressed in a similar fashion. About 10 to 12 millimeters is cut off the top of the tibia and replaced with a metal cap. The metal cap on the tibia is able to accept a plastic piece that is actually locking into it. So in essence, the end of the femur and the inferior thigh bone is capped with a metal cap. The top of the leg bone is capped with a metal cap also, but it has a plastic insert, so you end up with metal against plastic. For the patella or the kneecap, the backside of the kneecap is also trimmed approximately 10 to 12 millimeters, and then it is resurfaced with a plastic button. So again, for the kneecap and thigh bone articulation, it's plastic on the backside of your kneecap against metal on the end of the thigh bone. And then that repair is done, and as soon as that's done, you're able to move right away. So patients are able to walk on the same day of surgery. They're able to lift their knee up much more easily and raise their leg and have control so that they can get home quicker and have less pain.